In this video, we'll show you how to navigate RPR property search and search results. We'll focus on searching residential properties for now, but this toggle allows you to switch between a commercial and residential property search at any time. Also, note that all other types of search, neighborhoods, market activity, schools, and site selection, can be accessed from the top navigation research menu. Begin your property search by entering a specific address, APN, or listing ID in the location field to go directly to the property. If you're searching by multiple APNs or listing IDs at one time, use the semicolon to separate each. In this case, you'll be taken to search results displaying each property. Or you can search for properties in a general area. To do that, enter a neighborhood, zip code, city, or other defined geography into the location field. As you type, RPR will auto-suggest results based on the location nearest to you. If you select the name of the auto-suggest, your search will be automatically executed. You can still filter your results further down, but now you'll be doing this from a search results page and not the home page. Note that RPR has a max number of properties that you can search. Once your search area exceeds 5,000 properties, RPR will show a message requesting that you adjust your search filters to narrow down your results. Back to our main search, you'll begin to narrow down your results by selecting the property status for your search. Are you looking for properties that are for sale, active under contract, or are you looking for off-market public records? Also, each status has a calendar that can be used to set the date parameters that will restrict your search to that exact time period. Select your property type, price or lease price, beds, and baths. Note that depending on the size of your screen, main filter options might not show on the main search bar, but are always available via the expanded search. Select the filters icon to expand to the advanced search. You'll immediately see the count of properties matching your criteria. This is a helpful reference that will allow you to better pinpoint the specific properties you're looking for. Advanced search filters include distressed actions, open houses, land use, and miscellaneous fields, such as occupancy type, owner name, year built, time owned, and keyword search. Now that we've gone over the basics, let's try out a property search. In this example, we're looking for properties that are for sale in Scottsdale, Arizona. We wanted only single-family residences, and we need homes with a minimum of 3 bedrooms and 2 bathrooms. It's also important that the property has a pool. We'll use our basic and advanced filters and select Update and Search. We arrive at the search results on the List view. To continue narrowing down your results, select the Filters icon and adjust the parameters of your search. Click Update and Search to refresh what's seen on the page. You can also quickly sort your results by using this drop-down or simply by clicking one of the column headers. Save properties by clicking the heart icon. The property is automatically named after the street address, but you can type in a new name if desired. Then select Save, and the property will be added to your saved properties. Your saved properties will be listed on the home page or accessed from the top navigation by choosing My Work and My Saved Properties. If you're looking for a printable view of the search results, select the properties you want by using the corresponding checkboxes and then selecting Print. A window will open allowing you to print only selected properties or all results. One thing to note here is that all results will print the properties currently showing on your screen. If you have a large number of properties to print, make sure to scroll to the bottom of the screen to view all your results. From the results list, you can also create mailing labels or similar data export into CSV. Do that by clicking Mailing Labels from your search results and then walking through the on-screen prompts. Or go straight to creating a report by selecting Create Report. If you select one property, you'll be directed to the property report, and if you select multiple properties, you'll be directed to create a market activity report. View your properties the way you want to view them. This current view is the list view. You can change to a photo grid view or to the map view by selecting these icons. The photo grid view gives you a way to view larger photos on the property. And finally, you can view properties on the map view. We'll go into further details on map searches in the map search and analysis video, but from this view, you can further define your own search areas by drawing them on the map or by displaying the outlines of geographies such as neighborhoods, zip codes, school attendance zones, and more. Once you've found a property that you want to review further, select it to view the full property details. We hope you found this tutorial on searching properties helpful. And be sure to subscribe to the RPR YouTube channel. It's an easy way to learn more about RPR features and tools and stay current on updates and improvements.